Dear learner, I am Dr. Ganesh Bansode. Today we will study the important insect pest of Goa, their occurrences, life cycle, nature of damage and control measures to be followed. The insect pest infestation is a major limiting factor in production of Goa. About 80 species of insect have been recorded on Goa tree, which affecting yield and quality of fruits. Fruit flies, bark eating caterpillar, mealybug and spiraling white fly are considered as a major insect pest of Goa. The fruit fly is the most destructive pest in the production of Goa. Fruit flies are polyphagous pests, that means feeding on variety of cultivated crop plants and as such are of great economic importance. In Goa, fruit flies occurs throughout the year. The peak activity is observed mostly in fruiting period. Adult female lay eggs in outer skin of physiological mature fruits. Maggots are without legs and having pointed black head. Pupation takes place in the soil. Adult are brown color with hyaline, that is translucent wing and yellow legs. Total life cycle is completed in 20 to 35 days. Maggot is the only damaging stage. Maggot feeds on pulp of the fruit. On completion of full development, the maggot bore the hole and exit out from the fruit to the ground for pupation. Egg laying damage in the form of minute depression may be seen from outside. The affected fruit rot and drop prematurely, and such fruit are not suitable for consumption. Fruit fly damage can be managed by destroying the fallen and infected fruit along with maggots. It helps to prevent the further buildup of population. Similarly, raking of soil around the tree basin also helps in checking the pest population as the pupae pupate in the soil. For killing the male fruit flies, hang methyl eugenol based trap at height of 5 to 6 feet from ground level. Per acre, such trained traps are found useful. Planting of Osium santalum, that is tulsi plant, will also help in capturing male fruit flies. Another important pest is bark eating caterpillar. This pest also damages the pomegranate, citrus and mango. Bark eating caterpillar occurs throughout the year. Adult female lays reddish color eggs under loose bark or in cracks and in crevices in cluster. Caterpillars are pinkish white with brownish spot. Adult moth are white with pair of small black dots on thorax and wings. Total life cycle is completed in more than 4 months. The damaging stage of bark eating caterpillar is larva only. The newly hatched larva feed on the bark. Larva cover the bark by ribbon like silken web made up of wood chips and excreta pellets. Holes on the trunks, wood dust and excreta hanging in the form of web around the affected portion are typical symptoms of bark eating caterpillar. Older trees are more prone to this pest. Early diagnosis with symptom is important. Hence, regular monitoring to orchard is suggested for the management of bark eating caterpillar. To keep the orchard clean and avoid the overcrowding of trees will reduce the damage of bark eating caterpillar. The timely removal of webs around the affected portion and kill the caterpillar by inserting the iron spike in shelter hole of borer. Further, insert the cotton swab, soak in the petrol or dichlorohos in the hole and seal it with mud. This will kill the larval stage. Next important pest is mealybug. Mealybug is polyphagous pest, that is feeding on various host, namely grapes, pomegranate, custard apple and mango. Mealybug occurs throughout the year. Peak activity of mealybug is observed mainly during fruiting season. Less temperature and high humidity is found favorable for the increasing mealybug population. Female lays orange color eggs in loose cottony oocytes. Crawler nymphs are orange color. Adult female are pinkish and sparsely covered with white wax. Its life cycle is completed in 20 to 35 days. The life cycle of mealybug consists of eggs, nymphs and adults. Damaging stage is both nymph and adult. Mealybugs suck the sap from leaves, shoot, fruit, and they also secrete honeydew-like substance which hampers the photosynthesis activity of plant. Collection and destruction of affected plant parts, pollen and infected fruit will check the further multiplication of mealybug. Pruning of overcrowded branches and raking of soil around the tree basin helps in checking the mealybug population. For prevention of mealybug traveling from soil to stem of tree, wrap the sticky brand around the tree stem. Remove the alternate host like hibiscus, okra, etc. of hibiscus family. Frequently release the predator like Australian ladybird, that is Cryptolemus montrezeri, during morning hours to kill the life stages of mealybug. If necessary, spray the Lecanicillium lecani at the rate 6 gram per liter of water during early stage of infestation. Spiraling white fly is an introduced polyphagous pest of guava. It occurs throughout the year with more population during October and November month. Adult female lay eggs in spiraling pattern, that is concentric circle, on the undersurface of leaves. Nymphs are short, glass-like rod of wax along the side of body, and adults are powdery white. The life cycle is completed in 25 to 30 days. Adult and nymphs assemble heavily on the lower surface of leaf, suck the sap, and cause premature leaf drop and chlorosis. Honeydew secretion also leads to the development of sooty mold fungus on affected part. For the management of white flies, destroy the damaged leaves along with its life stages. For trapping the adult flies, use yellow sticky trap at the rate 10 traps per acre. Release the predator, namely Chrysoparla carnea, at the rate 4000. Per acre to kill the all life stages. Conserve naturally occurring spiraling white fly parasitoid Encarsia species by avoid the spraying of insecticide. Avoid the water stressed condition, it will help to keep the white fly population at minimum level. Early detection, sanitation and integration of appropriate control measure discourage the development of insect pest population and increase the yield of guava crop. Thank you.